Oh, well, welcome, folks. You're looking at the XCRK studios. Yeah, that's where XCRK is, or has been moved to. Thought you'd like to check that out. Just seeing, there's the DX440, and, you know, my 10-channel scanner, another Radio Shack mixer, and the telephone, the other mixer, the reverb generator, turntable, and microphone, headphones, and mic stand, and let's see, here we have two cassette decks, a CD player, and a VCR, and a third portable CD player on top. And right here we have a reel-to-reel Akai X150D and an 8-track player that also records. Good shape too. Good condition. And in the corner we have our Part 15 FM stereo transmitter by Oregon Comm Systems. Yeah. You might want to have Animal check on that for the in the catalog there for you. Whoa. See, PL259 with RG8 RCA cables there for inputs left and right, and it has its own power adapter. So what I'd like to do for you now is turn it, but it's kind of hard, so you can see the front of it. It has a PLL light, which indicates the PLL is operating, and a power switch. That's pretty much about the gist of it. So that's the transmitter there. Oh, let's see, where do I start? Well, monitor radio. And then I have, of course, a guest microphone in the studio here for everyone. A couple of things I'd like to mention. One is these cassette decks are just standard issue tape players. As you can see, they're electronic tape decks with solenoids in them, but one's Iowa and one's a Radio Shack. Radio Shack and Iowa, Iowa apparently made it for Radio Shack, but it's the same exact model. My VCR, which I didn't buy to use on the studio, but ended up here anyway, is a Hitachi. That's about a $700 VCR, so that ended up on the studio, and then I of course have my Radio Shack CD player. This mixer is an Aldus mixer, this mixer board here that goes, that's just a DJ mixer. It's nothing professional, no studio quality. Well, I guess you might say it could be used for that, but it's not a great thing there. And then the phone patch, which does hook into the mixer through the transformer that I put out. Animal told me how to do that. If you want to know how to make a nice speakerphone phone patch, talk to Animal about that. He's got a great idea, and that's what we use here. So, a nice thing to do. Now, if you're running a shortwave transmitter or even an FM Part 15, one thing I've done, you'll notice here, my portable CD player has foil all over it. And there also is a, if I can find it real quick here, there's a wire right there. Let me back off on the magnification here. I don't know if you're going to be able to see that, but there's a wire right here. And that keeps, because I was having a problem, whenever I get my hand near it, it would start skipping and quitting. Well, come to find out, the transmitter was RF in the CD player. So I had to cover it with foil and run a ground wire to keep the RF out of it. Doesn't look the greatest, but it does work. It keeps the RF off. I got foil running on the bottom and then on the top, and I got it split so I can lift the lid. See, I have that so I can lift the lid up like that, so that keeps it from getting RF into there. One thing I do recommend is grounding the mixer. Depending on the mixer you got, I guess just ground it to the case. I use an 8-foot copper ground rod that I picked up at any electrical supply house should have them. Run it outside and run reasonably thick wire for grounding, which does work real nice. I've grounded both cassette decks, VCR, CD player, mixer, and reel-to-reel and 8-track to keep the RF out of all of those. So that works really well. Also, your turntable, some of the ones that come with a home stereo have a clip-on for ground. It'd be a good idea to ground that too as well to keep the RF out of the turntable. It likes to go in record players really well. They get nasty feedback and real bad sound. So you might want to do that. I hook the scanner in just to have sometimes put stuff out over the air. Let's say if we're having an emergency with the weather or something, I can put it out over the air right off the weather frequency. That's for part 15. Basically, that's what I do right now. I do some recording for XERK for upcoming broadcasts, but as it goes, the studios here are mainly used for what I call it as Wolf FM, WOLF. I operate at 91.1 megahertz, so kind of part of the Wolf net. You can talk to Animal about that, he'll know. So, it's kind of part of the Wolf net here. And we're on FM, and that's there. I'd like to go outside and show you the antenna, but it's very, very muddy out. We're getting severe rains here, so I really can't do that, or I'll step off into, I never get out of, get home, back into the house. So, and this is the rest of the studio here. I keep the music there, and all the tapes. I even have some 8-tracks there, and my little listening post right there. My DX440, and of course the additional mic there if I have studio guests. So that's pretty much the studio. A couple of hints and tips here, I guess, dealing with the FCC. If you're ever going to have something like this for a pirate station, don't ever broadcast where you have your studio, because man, they like to get a hold of this equipment, and if they can get you twice, they'll get a search warrant, come in and take it. So my best advice is do not broadcast within, where you're going to have your studio. If you're going to have a nice studio, make tapes, take them out, have someone else relay them, or do a mobile broadcast, or do a broadcast in the woods. Would be my best advice to you. So that would be a good way to do it. Let's see. Let me think what else. Well, everybody knows, anybody who... you guys are watching out there, and been reading the Ace past issues back before when XERK supposedly got busted. Brad Gilland and Oliver Crotch Long were trying to give me the green shaft. So, and I believe Animal's got a tape to give some of the people who'd like one to listen to of an XERK broadcast. So, hope you enjoy that. So this is the studio here. This is not the original place XERK was set up at, by the way. This is not the original location. I have moved since, and I'm not in the area of where XERK originally had taken place. I do not have a shortwave antenna up right now because I take all my broadcasts out and run them somewhere else. I try to keep the XERK and the Wolf FM separate, so there's no problem there. But I can do XERK tapes, and I have some of the XERK material right in here as well to make broadcasts. So if there's something coming up I need to do, I can do it in a matter of minutes. Let's see. Who are we going to say hello to out there? Let's see. AJ Michaels from Action Radio will say hello to you, and also Fearless Fred from Radio Garbanzo, man, that FCC commercial. The FCC recruiter commercial was awesome. I thought that was so cool. I was tripping out. And I'd like to say hi to Phil Music. Say hello to you. And let's see if he's around there. Let's see who else might be there that I know. I don't think he'll be there. I don't know. Let's see. Andrew Yoder. I haven't talked to you. I think you called our station one or two times, but hadn't really spoke to you in any great length. How's it going? And hope you're doing okay. And everyone gets to see the video here, and any DXs out there just scanning the studio here. So that's what this consists of. My studio here. Zoom up so you can see that. The 8-track player. And there's the real wheel right here. So you get to see that. And of course the cassette deck. CD player and VCR. And back over to the mixer. And the telephone. Turntable. Additional mixer. And the nice monitor radio. And the scanner. And all the way back on over to the additional studio microphone. Well, that's about it for the studio here. Like I said, I'd like to get outside and show everyone the antenna. My FM antenna is supported on about 34 feet on a Radio Shack push-up mast. In fact, it was the original push-up mast we'd used for the shortwave station. So that's what we'd used there. The antenna is just a very simple ground plane antenna made out of an old Radio Shack CB antenna. So it's a very simple design there. Very, very simple. And I'm running 50 foot of RG8 coax down here. The PL259's on the ends of it, so that's what we got here for the coax to the antenna, and then the 8 foot grounding rod right outside, which the transmitter and all the audio equipment is grounded, so makes it real nice, keeps the RF out of everything, and good clean sound. Did have a compressor there, but that's in for repair. That was sitting right up there on top. Of the last cassette deck up here, that's where it was sent, where that CD player is now. But that's being sent off for repair, so we'll have that back in no time. So I hope everyone's having a good time at the gathering. I would have liked to made it, but pressing matters do occur. Oh, there's the time. Things do come up, so I couldn't make it, but I sure damn tried hard to get there. Tried to get the arrangements so I could get there, but it just didn't work. Well, like I say, that's what happens. Well, folks, appreciate you watching the video here, and talk to Anno about the XERK tapes. There's one broadcast, one or two or something there he's got for you, for anybody who'd be interested in a tape there. Take home with you. And I should have sent some QSL, but didn't get a chance. So, hope you enjoy the video here, and hope everyone has a great time, and keep on rolling out those pirate broadcasts. We want to see those keep going. We got something coming up here in a few months for us. All right, folks, we are here. We got outside. Thought I'd let you see the FM antenna way up there. Oh, my neck, I can't handle that. That's where it's at, way up there. So that's the FM antenna. Coax running inside. Ground rod is down there. The whole shot. And there's the Wolf FM satellite dish that's not quite operational because it's too muddy to get everything to put it up. It's raining too much. We just got a break in the rain right now. Thank God. Oh, I was going to drive to Kingsville and go get a shot of the monitoring post for you, but I didn't get time to do that. So, we'll be back in a minute here. Oh, we're back. Minor disturbance there. Oh. Looking around here, neighborhood. It's all fenced in, so we have a fortress here to keep the FCC out, which I don't foresee any reason to have them out, because I only have the Part 15, but if they wanted to come in here and see the station, I wouldn't let them in anyway. Tell them to screw off. Satellite dish here, which will be operational in a very short time. The mast antenna, that's just a Radio Shack push-up mast that is strapped to the house. So, that's all we're running right here. Yeah, simple design. And the RG8 coax down and on in, and the ground rod with the wire there. So that's pretty much it. So hope you enjoy the video here, and hope the gathering goes real well. Wish I could be there to make it, but only on video. So thank you very much. Yeah, say hi to the Radio Animal, of course, who's presenting this to you. So Animal, hope you're having a nice time there, and say hello to everyone from Wild Steve and whoever else sees the video. Hello to you. And like I say, keep looking for an upcoming XERK broadcast of 7435 kilohertz in the near future. Yeah, that's our frequency. So we'll be on in the near future, and hope you get to watch that reel. Listen for that and send in for your QSLs when it comes out. We do not use the Pittsburgh drop. So for our address there. So if you would like to write to me at XERK Radio, care of the Pittsburgh Drop with the Radio Animal. So, alrighty. Ooh, there's a dog barking. I don't know where it's from, but we'll be back in a little bit, I think. No, I think that's going to do it. We're running out of time here. So, everyone, have a great time, and see you later.
Hey, Grandma, the big eyes you have.
The bandits see you win.
My Grandma, what a big nose you have.
The bandits smell you win.
Grandma, what big ears you have!
Better listen to me.